In today's news, we reveal the 10 most dangerous electrical blunders that contractors see in people's homes. We learn how full your order book is in our weekly eFIXX survey, and we hear about the electricians who detained a violent knife man using just cable ties. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Schneider Electric, whether you're listening in the van, on site, down at the wholesale counter, or if you're a designer and you've made it safely to your desk, wherever you are, I hope your week is off to a great start. I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And as always, don't forget to listen out for the two words that I've been challenged to slip into today's show. Comment below or tag us on social media if you think you've spotted them. If you've got a story you'd like to feature in the news, then please click the link in the show notes for more information on how to do so. And if you're watching on YouTube, you'll note that I'm on location in our Skipton studio this week, and you may like to know that an audio-only version of this video goes out on all major podcasting platforms, so you can listen to us while in the van or on site. And if you're already listening to the audio version, why not check us out on YouTube for some extra visuals as well. A survey out this week has disclosed the dodgy DIY doings that professional electricians are seeing in people's homes. Turns out almost half of Brits have acted as an unsuspecting saboteur by meddling with their home's electrics. So Electrical Direct, the specialist retailer of electrical products, asked hundreds of electrical contractors to reveal the most common errors that people make and then rank them in terms of severity. At the very top of the league of shame is leaving plastic sheathed cable unprotected. This clearly exposes them to snagging and cuts, which could lead to fires or even lethal shocks. People living in Northern Ireland are most guilty of making this top clanger, with 40% of electricians in the country saying they see it regularly. Clearly, householders need to engage an electrician to run bare cable safely through conduit. The second biggest mistake is leaving switches or outlets loosely connected. This can, of course, disrupt the power supply or worse, allow live wires to wiggle loose, exposing them to fingers. This means that there's a potential risk of electrocution or fire. Other common howlers include cutting the wires too short, recessing boxes behind the wall surface, and installing cable without a clamp. Homeowners also overstacking extension leads and electrical outlets in a bid to plug in more and more devices. They connect wires outside electrical boxes, overfill those boxes, and even make the basic error of reversing line and neutral wires. DIYers often connect an RCD backwards, and they install electrical outlets too close to water in breach of regulations. Electrical Direct's chief, Dominic Sanford, has now warned that people should stay away from certain electrical jobs that can lead to injuries. We happily concur and remind householders that all work needs to be conducted by a qualified professional and be compliant with all the latest changes to the 18th edition of the wiring regulations. To help you keep up with those changes, Schneider Electric have produced a really useful ebook. This details the updates to the 18th edition as well as the latest products to help installers comply. The amendments include changes to special location installations, including solar and electric vehicle systems, prosumer low voltage electrical installations, and the need for systems that can both produce and store energy. Watch out for one of our videos this coming week on the subject of prosumers as well. Installation requirements for fire risk buildings, including escape routes and cabling, and the removal of the CRL calculation and the increased need for surge protection. Nico van der Merwe, Vice President of Home and Distribution UK at Schneider Electric, sees the changes as a great opportunity for the electrical industry. And he believes that the company's lineup of products will support the trade in complying with the latest regs. For our bite-sized take on Amendment 2, check out the video in the link above my head or in the description below. Speaking of Schneider, we're just going to pause the podcast for a moment while I say a big thank you to the company for supporting today's show. Schneider Electric are the huge company that produce electrical equipment across a number of fields, and they're extremely supportive of the electrical industry, contributing to various good causes, including our very own College Connections campaign. So we're extremely grateful for their ongoing support. Okay, on with the show. Another great reference guide we're loving this week is a brilliant pocket guide app from the NICEIC. This is free to download and is available to all NIC certified businesses. It contains a bank of no fewer than 35 technical reference guides, all updated to the Second Amendment of BS7671 where relevant. There are also really handy calculators for checking ZS values, adiabatic equations, conductor resistance and length and design current. It's fully searchable and is optimized for iPhones, Android phones and tablets. Another set of innovations to help you do your job better has been unveiled by Draper. In fact, the 103-year-old family firm has introduced no fewer than 200 new models. I know this because the new 1,000-page catalogue landed on our desk last week with a thump, almost knocking over our giant Sports Direct mugs. My highlights would be the new XP1000 range of VDE compliant screwdrivers and pliers, a series of heat guns, and the Bunker Secure Storage Box, which is designed to keep your tools safe from thieves. Keeping your whole van safe from thieves is another matter entirely. In fact, annual thefts are predicted to double in the next decade. Londoners are most often the victim, and the top model targeted by thieves is the Mercedes Sprinter 313 CDI. Two-thirds of break-ins include the theft of tools, and the research shows that only 1% are ever recovered due to their high resale value, leaving a devastating impact on electricians and their ability to service their customers and provide for their families. And those customers are asking for more and more work, according to this week's eFIXX survey. We asked how your business outlook today compares to this time last year, and it's looking pretty good. 43% of you told us that you're busier than usual with lots of work booked ahead. One in five of you reported being fully occupied now but don't have much forward bookings. 13% of you disclosed that it's quieter than usual with only some jobs coming up. And one in 10 of you quoted the special saying, "This town, ooh ooh, is coming like a ghost town." That's the closest I'll ever come to singing in public. Let's hope trade picks up for us all when people get back from their holidays. In the meantime, here's some dates for your diary. The Green Home Festival opens on Monday the 8th of August as part of the Edinburgh Festival Fringe. This is a week-long series of events delivering practical assistance and advice to help Scotland become a net zero nation. It consists of 12 in-person and virtual presentations on green topics targeting homeowners, contractors, housing associations, and local authorities. Screwfix Live is back in Farnborough after 2 years of virtual outings. The free-to-enter show is returning to Farnborough International Exhibition and Conference Centre from Friday the 23rd of September to Sunday the 25th of September. Expect to see 170 top brands of kit, product demonstrations, giveaways, and lots more. Screwfix will also host the final of the Screwfix Top Tradesperson competition. This annual event will see 10 skilled trade finalists go head-to-head from across the UK and the Republic of Ireland to be crowned Screwfix Top Tradesperson 2022. Participants who register and visit the event will have the chance to put their hands on an exclusive deals and a free goodie bag. Also in September is the UK's first event dedicated to sustainable lighting. Called Circular Lighting Live 2022, it's a one-day conference and exhibition taking place on Thursday the 22nd of September in central London. I've put the links to all the events in the show notes for you. And this is the part of the show where we like to say hello to one of our devoted followers. This week we're saying what ho to Tyler Harris, an electrical apprentice who Gary had the pleasure of meeting on site recently. He assured us that he's an avid listener of Electrical News Weekly, and we thought we'd put that to the test. So if you are indeed listening, Tyler, drop us a comment or tag us on social media, and thanks very much for watching and following us. Hopefully our content will help you on your career journey. Now to electric vehicle news. In last week's eFIXX News Weekly, we reported how Fuuse, the company which writes the operating system for charging points, had teamed up with EV Comply, the firm whose app helps installers commission the chargers. The idea was to make it easier to install and use those chargers. Well, this week comes news of another strategic partnership as players in the EV world scramble to buddy up. Jumptech, the charger installation platform, has announced a collaboration with the charger maker, Sevadis. The idea is to provide electrical installers with an efficient and streamlined charge point installation process. The Jumptech platform will simplify the install process for Sevadis installers, commercial customers, and EV drivers. As you may recall, Sevadis partnered with Yes Electrical as their strategic wholesale partner, providing installers with access to Sevadis' full range of charging equipment. And finally, we turn to the tale of two heroic electricians from Chichester. Alex Carruthers and Josh Hawes of Impact Electrical Solutions were working on site when they heard the desperate cries of a woman from inside a nearby flat. The duo entered the property only to be confronted with a man wielding a knife. Without a thought for their own safety, they tackled him and managed to wrestle the weapon out of his hands. They then had the problem of how to restrain him and protect the woman. The answer? They grabbed some cable ties and tied him up until the police arrived. The woman has since recovered from her injuries. Detective Constable Kat Wilkins says she believes that the electrical contractors saved the woman's life. She said that it was a violent and unprovoked attack, and the aggressor has been sentenced to 16 years in prison. A High Sheriff's award of £500 will be given to both of the heroes. We do like a happy ending here at eFIXX. Coming up this week on our YouTube channel, we've got a great Q&A video shot on location at the installer show about the rise of the prosumer. We've got a fascinating interview with the good folks at Marshall Tuflex, who are just about to celebrate their 80th anniversary. And we meet Victor Mewin, the CEO of a business that's like the Deliveroo of the electrical world. Plus, we'll have the usual mix of shorts and social media fun, so stay connected for all that. If you think you know the words that we've smuggled into today's show, pop your guess into the comments and we'll dig out a goodie bag prize to the first ones to get the right answers. We had quite a number of guesses for last week's words. Bill Dudson came volleying in first with emus and wallabies, but they were a bit close together, Bill. I like to space them out a little bit. Regular commenter Sergio Fernandez guessed lackadaisical while on his way to the Outer Hebrides for work. Quite a journey, that one. Tom Taylor may have been guessing my Doctor Who-esque quote of illuminescent solar concentrator, or he may have just enjoyed saying it, but either way, it wasn't right. And someone who simply goes by Dan stuck with that theme, guessing lackadaisical and Doctor Who, but there was only one person in the comments who got both right last week, and that was Callum Clark, who came in with lackadaisical and emu. So very well done to you, Callum. Please make sure that you click the link in the description below or in the show notes to make sure that you can claim your prize. The good news is Joe 2.0 is back from his Turkish sojourn, where he informs me the food was glorious. In fact, he had a liver kebab, which was the best he's ever had, apparently. Anyway, the point is that prizes will be getting posted out now, won't they, Joe? Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Schneider Electric. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque-calibrated arm.